Hi guys, happy December 10th. It is the 10th day of Vlogmas, which is wild. Well, actually this would be the 11th. I got kind of messed up this weekend when I was at our camping trip, so I'm trying to bounce back. Instead of, if you saw yesterday's video, I did a Q&A instead of an all day thing because what I was supposed to film for today's video, I was driving home all day in a car and I was hungover and tired. So I'm doing my best to bounce back. So right now I'm home. I just got back from a meeting that was really exciting and has to do with our wedding. So as soon as I can share that kind of stuff, I will. I lost my voice this weekend if I sound weird. Yeah, all right, bye. Hi guys, okay, so I just got a bunch of packages in the mail and not doing a lot today, so I need the Vlogmas content. So I'm gonna show you what I got. Pretty excited about most of these. Okay, so first and foremost, I know what one this is. Very excited about it. Oh, it's pretty epic. Okay, ready? It's gonna look weird because of my shirt that I'm wearing today, but can you even? I am never taking this off. I really quickly just wanted to show you all the hoodie I just got in the mail from Shutterfly. I will be living in this forever. Okay. The next thing that I got. Okay, so really quick, I'm gonna show you our Christmas cards, the ones that I decided on. If I can get it out. Okay, so I went with this one. It says, Merry everything and happy always, which I like just love that saying for a Christmas card. And then it's got both of our proposals from this year, and then obviously we had to add Paisley in. And then on the back, I just added this like little text just to make it fun. And then these are the envelopes I decided to go with. So the front says sending love to, and then I have like on all these other cards, everyone's addresses and names actually printed, but I wanted to get a couple extra just in case I forgot anyone. And on the back, it says, love, Kate and Sarah. That's us. If you guys cannot tell, I'm obsessed with the fact that we were on Ellen and I never want to forget it. So I ordered this magnet for our fridge. Yeah, I was on Ellen, whatever. I'm sweating. So, when I was in New York, okay, I met with this awesome PR agency called Allison Broad, and they basically let me like go ham with a bunch of the products they represent. So I will show you guys some of that, but there's so much shit in here. Just to give you an idea, this is all of the shit that I got. I got Lime Crime Softwear Blush. This is a vegan and cruelty-free brand, and so I'm really excited. I've never really tried anything by them, so I'm super, super excited to give them a try. And then I got a an Urban Decay Color Brow Pencil, which I'm pretty sure they're also cruelty-free. I got some shampoos and conditioners. I got another brow blade. I got a toner. Then I got Get Even Cold Press Peel Pads. I heard these are really, really good for exfoliating, which is good because my skin is just constantly like flaking. This is the Bliss Super Rich Moisturizer. They said this thing is like super insane if you're dry, which I am. Dragon's Blood Hyaluronic Moisturizer. I'm not a beauty blogger, obviously. Lancome Dual Finish Highlighter. I'm a hoe for a good highlight. Oh, it's beautiful. Am I a beauty blogger now? Okay, that's all I'm gonna show you guys for now because it's probably getting boring for you, but I'm very, very excited. If you have any questions about how those products work, let me know. And yeah, bye. For my gift at the cabin, I got a boob oracle. So you shake it and ask it questions.
You can't see through it.
What should I ask it?
Will Kate ever burp another word besides fucking yeah?
They don't know about that.
Okay, well, let me tell you about it. Kate, anytime she burps, burps the word yeah. It's so weird.
It's only with Sarah. I don't do it with anyone else. It says breast idea ever.
Good. That means she will stop burping the word yeah. I fucking hate it.
Okay. We're going to bed.
Good night.
Can you taste my watermelon mask?
I forgot that you had that on your face. Zoom in so you can show them what you look like.
They can see.
Looks like the Tin Woman.
Okay. Vlogmas day 11. We out.
Vlogmas is fun.
It's because she just gets to be in it when she wants and she doesn't have to do any of the work for it.
Correct. It's not my job.
Okay. Alright, goodbye. See you tomorrow.
Bye.
Bye. Hello, everybody. Good morning. It is December... What is today? 12th? 13th? I honestly don't know. It is Wednesday. It's really crazy that ever since I started working from home, I don't know the day. I'm getting ready because I need to shoot some things today for some brand deals. And yeah, I just picked my... Another thing I'm doing today that I'm mostly excited for is I pretty much only talk about my struggle with my parents and sometimes anxiety on my platform, on my Instagram. But today I am sharing a little bit about my struggle with my body and how I can hide what I want to hide on Instagram and online and not let you guys see the parts of me that I don't like. And today I am going to share them. The fan in here is really loud. It's very annoying. I'm very sorry. The lighting in here is terrible, so I'm very, very sorry for that. But what I was saying is I recently started following, no, that's not true. I probably followed her for like a year and a half now. Her name is The Birds Papaya. It's Sarah on Instagram. There are a lot of inspiring people I follow that I truly like following, and I love what they do. She is the most unbelievable person that I've ever followed. She's so honest and so inspiring and open and warm and welcoming, and like her page does so much for me that I want to take a little bit of what she does, because she's a lot about body positivity, and put it onto my page because I know how much it's helped me, and I can only imagine how much it would help the people who follow me. I'm a little nervous for sure because I don't like my body very much of the time. And I want to get out of that. So I'm just going to put it out there and we'll see how you guys react to it. But just know that when like people are posting things like this and they get nasty comments, they probably have so much anxiety the morning of or the day of that they're going to post. And they're putting themselves out there and being super vulnerable online. And I know that that's a risk that you have to take when you have a following online. But like, it's just really, really scary. And I'm nervous, but I'm excited because I don't just want to be defined by being a lesbian, which is something that I've done to myself over the past few years. So yeah, I will keep you guys posted throughout the day as I start shooting my deals and stuff. And I look like a penis. Hi guys, I am editing this and realized that I never recorded anything else the day that I recorded this. So I am going to link my post that I talked about down below, and also The Birds Papaya's Instagram, just in case you are interested in checking her out, which I highly suggest that you do. And that's it for day 11, or the 11th of December, and now we're getting into the rest of the week.
Hi guys, so we are in Ohio. I am in a wedding tomorrow.
Your best friend's wedding?
My best friend Megan's wedding. I look pretty orange. I did two layers of self-tanner last night.
Yeah, I helped tan. It was fun.
After a very large Christmas sale. So my hands just don't make sense at all. So I have to redo that. But we're going to a vegan breakfast.
The Root Cafe. The Root Cafe.
The Root Cafe.
The Root Cafe.
We've been singing it all morning. No. So we're going there now. I decided that instead of posting every single day, I'm just gonna post.
Is that what I look like?
instead of posting every day this week, because I got off track from the cabin and this wedding, that I'm just going to make a week-long vlog, and then I'll jump back in the last week and post every day the last week of, why? Of Christmas. So yeah, we'll see you later.
Bye.
Bye. We're not going to the Root Cafe. They only had two vegan options for breakfast, and I wouldn't have liked either of them because I'm very picky. Sarah's disappointed. She really wanted to go there. What can I do? We're going to the Cleveland Vegan.
Look at my little bun.
You look good.
This is Ohio Sarah.
Sarah!
After you finish your pieces, you just grab another chunk, get the rest away,
and
circle it on like this, you know, counterclockwise. Touch a little bit. When it hurts, you just let go, and then it's a curl.
You look good, babe. That's scary.
Grab a little more. Yeah, you'll see the after.
You know you're from Cleveland if you know what this is. If any of you know what this is,
Marks,
I will be so impressed. And that means that you grew up around where I grew up, because you only...
Are there only marks in Ohio?
Only in like this area.
Don't I look a little funky dunky?
I think it's because my lips are the same color as my face.
No, they're not at all, actually. Your face is tanner than your lips.
We're going to get pho!
What else is new?
That's really it. All we've been doing is eating.
Really?
Sarah got ready. Hi, everyone. Sarah and I are on our way to the rehearsal dinner.
Yep, the rehearsal dinner.
Rehearsal. That's it. Fucking bitch drives like a maniac all the time. And when she's supposed to be slowing down, somehow is going so fast every fucking time.
But that was perfect. And also, just because we have shit to talk about, don't be shitting on me.
It's true, her driving sometimes is scary. We fight about it.
I'm not your average twerker.
Where are you?
It's like super easy, guys. I'll show you a tutorial. Hey, my name's Cassidy. I'm from Cleveland, Ohio.
That's it?
And, let's get lit. That fucking... Okay, back to it. We're home. Oh, we're home. It was a long drive. We're gonna watch the L Word, the L Word Generation Q.
Season 2, episode 1. No, season 1, episode 2.
We're gonna rewatch episode 1, and I listened to a podcast called...
Oh my god, she needs to talk about this. Here, hold this so I can grab my mirror.
Okay, I listened to a podcast called...
You hold it further, hold it further.
The L Word Made Me Gay, and it's these two girls, Erin and Sarah, that talk about the L Word, and they just dissect it, and it's really fucking funny.
Okay. be better.
My vlogger.
I suggest it. I suggest it.
It's not even on you.
Watch it.
No.
Said it all.
Our nuptials.
We love the word nuptial.
Nuptial? How do you pronounce it properly?
Babe, how do you say it right? It's nuptials.
No, there's no Yule.
You say nuptials?
It's nuptials.
You're saying N-U-P-G-C-H-U-L-S.
Nuptial. No, it's because listen to how it's spelled. It's N-U-P-T-I-A-L. Where's the Yule? So the wedding that we were at was my best friend Megan. We met 6 years ago when we both worked at Chili's. And
it's a riveting story.
Video? No, it's a picture.
No, it's not. I can see the guy, you fucking asshole.
This is my end of the week long vlog. Vlogmas. I'll be back to scheduled business tomorrow.
Wait, hold on.
All right, bye.
What are you laughing?
It's just you. I love you.
I love you.